Thanks for stopping by. Today I'm going to share with you another haul. So last week I went to Michael's and I shared that haul with you too. Or if you haven't seen it, it will be loading soon. And then the next day my friend Jen, who I scrapbook with, she texted me at work and said, hey, you want to go to Archivers with me? They're having a sale and they have fancy pants 12 by 12 paper pads for $3.99. And I was like, yeah. So this is the paper pad that I picked up for $3.99, and it is the Little Sport. They had three or four different collections you could choose from, and they were $3.99. You can see right here is the price tag, $3.99. You were limited one, and you couldn't go back and get another one because it was only one, and they have you in their system. But it's really cute. I'm always looking for boy papers, and I wanted this collection when it was full price for $19. So I decided to go ahead and get this one since it was adorable. And you can use it for a lot of things, but I thought it's great paper choices for boys. So I picked that up, and that was the main reason why we went there, to snag one of these $3.99 paper pads. And my friend Jen got the gray colored one that was really cute. And while I was there, I decided to pick up some other items as well. I got the Snap Studio sticker letters, and you get 8 sheets in here. I've been meaning to pick this up for a long time because I think it's such a good value. You get so much. You get 8, all these colors here, and this is pretty old, but I sometimes don't have these smaller size letters, and sometimes the small ones aren't the right size. So grabbed that while I was there. I also grabbed these Heidi Swap arrows, the disco arrows, and these, they have a little section now they've brought back. For those of you who used to shop at Archivers, they used to have a hot spot, and everything was $1.99 all the time, and then they took it away. So now they have like two little areas in the center of my store where everything is $1.99, and there's a ton of Heidi Swap products, and I decided to get the black and blue arrows. They're really sequence arrows, basically. They're cute. And also while I was there, I wanted to pick up some of the enamel dots. So I picked up this one from Winter Wonderland, and this one was priced lower than the rest, and I'm not sure why, but I grabbed it. And I picked up one from My Girl. I love these bright, fun, like, colors, so cute. And then I picked up the collectible notable cute enamel dots, so I got those 3 packs. I also picked up in that same $1.99 area the Heidi Swap neon letters. How fun are those? I love that they're textured. They have a little dimension, but they're still flat. I love that. They're glossy, and they'll be so much fun to play with. And you know, you can pick all this Heidi Swap stuff up at Michael's now, but these two things at Michael's are full price, like $3.99 and $4.99. Why not just, if you have Archivers, you can go get some of the embellies over there for $1.99. I was really excited to see these. They're from the DIY shop Crepe Paper, and they're the photo overlays. You get 14 in here. This is another item that I wanted from CHA. I was so excited to find these. And they just kind of give you that vignette look. You lay it over your photo, and you can see there's some back there with designs. They don't have any pictures on there, but these are going to be so cute and fun to work with. And I also picked up a mini theme pack from Echo Park, and this is older. It is the 4th of July collection, and the reason I picked this up was I really wanted like these red and blue and star patterns. I didn't really necessarily pick it up for 4th of July. My daughter is a gymnastics gal, and I wanted some papers to go with her leotard that she wore for her little gymnastics meet, and it had a silver blingy star on the front, and it was red. It was really pretty. And so I wanted to kind of do a theme with all the photos I took with stars and red and white. And so this was the perfect collection for that. And whatever I have left over, I'll just use for 4th of July pictures. So to go along with this collection here, the lady at Archivers found me this paper here. It's like the only one. It has the stars up at the top and, you know, gymnastics with the bar and stuff. So, or the beam. So I thought this will work good. I'm going to try to cut this up in several pieces and kind of layer it with my Kiwi Lane templates using some of these other papers so I can make several layouts. So that is, oops, one more thing. While we were at Archivers, not only did they have the 12x12 pack for the special that was going on, they also had this advertised, but they had these behind the counter. So you had to ask for it, and these are My Mind's Eye. They had two different ones to choose from. The 6x6 pad. They had the yellow one, and then they had this one here, and these were 99 cents that day. So I picked this particular collection up here, and yeah, they're older, but still fun, and for 99 cents, you can't pass it up. So this is my haul from Archivers, and then I just have a couple things from Hobby Lobby I'm just going to share with you super quick. I picked up these gymnastic stickers by Karen Foster to go with my daughter's layouts, just to add, like, maybe I could make this a flare and add some glossy accents over it, you know, just some of the words and stuff. And the little girl here, I love this. I mainly picked it up for this, Queen of the Beam, some of her beam shots. And then I picked up some alphabet stickers in brown foam by the Paper Studio. And I needed these for a title, and I needed this particular brown color. And I was so excited. I found this for $7.18. And this book I've been eyeing for a really long time. And when I saw it that cheap, I was like, yeah, I'm buying it. You can see it's fairly large. And this is a great book to have in your collection because it has words in it that you can choose, and sayings and poetry and quotes. And, you know, so you just find the topic. Like, this is a best friends, and you go through and you kind of find, oh, this would be a great title, or, oh, I really like that under my photo, or I love this quote I'm going to put on my page. And, you know, sometimes I'm not really good at trying to figure out what I'm going to title my layouts, so this will be great, or, you know, a saying to put inside of a card. So that was a good deal. So anyways, guys, this is my haul from Archivers and Hobby Lobby. I do have one more haul that I'll share with you from Kiwi Lane Designs. It's a small one, but I'll be back to share that one with you. Thanks, guys, for stopping by.